Hello, everyone. It's Aunt Fernita. We're studying Lesson 3, Miraculous Rescue. The message is God has a plan to take care of me. Our memory verse this week is one of my favorites. It's from Exodus chapter 14, verse 13. It says, "Stand firm, and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today." Brianna and her sister were so excited. Their parents were taking them and their little brother on a long trip across the country to visit relatives. They had never been to that place before, but Dad said that if they followed the directions from the GPS, they would be all right. A long time ago, God's people, the Israelites, went on a journey to a place they had not been before. They had God's GPS, God's powerful spirit, to guide them. The evening breeze off the Red Sea was refreshing. Asher welcomed the chance to rest his aching legs. What a whirlwind the last few days had been, killing the lamb, sprinkling its blood on the doorpost, then roasting it and eating it with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. It was the last meal he had eaten in the home he had ever known. He remembered the rest of that night. God's angel had swept through the land of Egypt and killed the firstborn in Egyptian homes. Pharaoh had been furious. He had ordered the Israelites out of the country immediately. Asher had felt excited, but anxious at the same time about leaving in the middle of the night, not knowing where they were going. Then he realized that God himself was leading them by a pillar of fire at night that turned into a pillar of cloud as the sun rose and the day dawned. Now that cloud had stopped by the Red Sea, and the Israelites were enjoying the rest. Asher wondered what might happen next. He didn't have to wait long. "Look! Out on the horizon! Can you see it? Can you hear it?" A messenger ran through the camp. "The Egyptians are coming!" Asher and the others jumped to their feet. Way out on the edge of the desert, they could see a cloud of dust. They could hear the roar of a mighty army. Asher's heart jumped into his throat. Pharaoh must have changed his mind. The army was coming to take them back to Egypt. Panic swept through the crowd. "Where's Moses? Where's Moses?" the people wailed. "Why did he bring us out here to die? Was it because there were no graves in Egypt? It would have been better for us to be slaves in Egypt than to die out here in the desert." "Do not be afraid," Moses said firmly. The sound of his voice quieted the crowd. "Stand firm, and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today. The Egyptians you see today, you will never see them again. The Lord will fight for you. You only need be still." Asher watched as the cloud that had been resting by the Red Sea moved. It passed over the Israelite people and out into the desert. It finally rested between the Israelites and the Egyptians. Moses walked to the edge of the Red Sea and held his staff over the water. Gently at first, and then more strongly, Asher felt a wind blowing towards the water. With astonishment, he watched the wind blow the water aside. It was leaving a dry path through the Red Sea. "Come," ordered Moses. "The Lord is preparing a way of escape for you. He will gain glory through Pharaoh and all his horsemen." Joyfully, the people rushed forward. The wind continued to blow a dry path as thousands of Israelites stepped into the dry seabed. Asher hurried to follow the others across the dry seafloor. A wall of water stood on either side of him. The pillar of fire illuminated the way. All night, the huge crowd of Israelites hurried through the sea. As the last of the crowd reached the far side, they could hear the Egyptian army pursuing. Asher looked back to see the army rushing towards them. But something amazing was happening. Wheels were coming off of their chariots. There was confusion, and it looked like they were trying to turn around and go back to Egypt. Just then, Moses stepped to the bank of the Red Sea. As dawn broke, he once again stretched his hand over the sea. The waters flowed back together. In an instant, the sound of the Egyptian army was quieted. The soldiers and their chariots were all gone under the waves. The Israelite community just stared. They were too stunned to say a word. Then a roar erupted. "Sing to the Lord," the people shouted. "The Lord is my strength and my song." Asher joined them, shouting with all of his might. God had saved them.
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for gracelink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.